Here in the Liberty Square courtyard, directly across from the entrance to the Hall of Presidents, glistening in the sun, is the Liberty Bell. Cast from the same mold as the one used by John Pass and John Stowe to recast the original bell in Philadelphia in 1753, this bell was originally created to tour around the country during the bicentennial of the Constitution in 1987. It was put on display at the Magic Kingdom, where it proved so popular with guests that Disney asked whether they could keep it. Philadelphia made a gift of the bell to the Disney company, and in return, Walt Disney World paid for another duplicate to be cast. Disney installed the replica of the bell in Liberty Square in 1989 and created the Court of Flags, which surrounds the bell, with 13 flags representing the original 13 colonies and an American flag in the center. Oh, and if you notice that Pennsylvania is only spelled with one N on the bell, that's not a mistake. That spelling and the large vertical crack both appear on the original Liberty Bell. In the 1970s, a daily ceremony was held in Liberty Square in front of the Liberty Bell called the Sons and Daughters of Liberty. The ceremony involved a fife and drum corps marching with cast members in Revolutionary-era costuming. A boy and girl would then be chosen from the crowd to be the official Son and Daughter of Liberty and march with the unit, and they were awarded a certificate and medal. The ceremony no longer takes place in the Magic Kingdom, although a similar fife and drum corps performs multiple times on most days in front of the American Adventure Pavilion in Epcot's World Showcase. Right next to the Liberty Bell is the Liberty Tree. Like the Liberty Bell, it has its roots, pardon the pun, in real American history. The original Liberty Tree was christened in Boston in 1765 when the Sons of Liberty gathered beneath its boughs to protest the imposition of the Stamp Act. In the years that followed, almost every American town had a Liberty Tree as a symbol of freedom of speech and assembly. Since each lantern was distinctive to a particular household, hanging it on the tree was a secret code to let the rebel patriots know when and where the meeting was to be held. Here at Liberty Square, the 13 distinct lanterns were hung to represent the original 13 colonies. The Liberty Oak Tree in the Magic Kingdom is a real southern live oak, Quercus virginiana, and it's over 100 years old and was found here in Orlando, just 6 miles south from its present home in Liberty Square. At over 40 feet tall and 60 feet wide, and weighing more than 38 tons, it is by far the largest living specimen in the Magic Kingdom and probably one of the largest ever transplanted trees. To move it from its original location, Imagineer and landscaper Bill Evans had to come up with a creative method of relocating it, since just lifting it with a cable would have caused injury to the tree. So two holes were drilled horizontally through the sturdiest section of the trunk. The holes were filled with dowels, and a 100-ton crane lifted the tree by these rods, which were later removed and replaced with the original wood plugs. Unfortunately, the wood plugs had become contaminated, and a serious infection set in and rotted out a portion of the inside of the trunk. In order to save the tree, the plugs again were removed, the holes were now filled with cement, the disease areas were cleaned out, and a young Quercus virginiana was grafted onto the tree at its base, where it still grows today. Acorns from the tree have been responsible for the creation of countless new trees, both on and off Disney property over the years. In addition to its ties to American history, the Liberty Tree also has ties to Disney history as well, as the Liberty Tree was also a song by Tom Blackburn and George Bruns, heard in Disney's 1957 film Johnny Tremaine, based on the Esther Forbes novel. In the film, the title character is a silversmith's apprentice who joins the Boston Tea Party and helps to hang the lights on the Liberty Tree near the start of the Revolutionary War. And this reference to the character of Johnny Tremaine leads us to our next stop on the tour.